Cosy, mm-hmm. You are better than anybody I know at using humor in your songs, mm-hmm. and it's always been interesting to me because I remember when I first started writing, and I've watched this in others. It seems like so many of us, we start out, we want to write love songs, or we want to write, you know, about angst, or we want to write these serious songs, and we eschew the notion of humor because somehow that just seems less serious.
There you go.
There you go. And but what I know, and your songs have taught me that as much as anybody, is that one, it isn't easy, and two, it can be so effective as a means of communication. Talk a little bit about how you do that.
Well, I first want to say also, my family valued humor. They valued Tom Lehrer. Tom Lehrer was a big hit in our family, and he came to our house. My family, it was in New Hampshire, where if you are in the politics, you know, they come to your house. And they had a fundraiser, and Tom Lehrer came and played our piano. And he played, and I was 6 years old, and I sat there, and people laughed. And, you know, I could feel the energy in the room, so I was like, I'm going to be able to do this. But yes, songwriting, that people ask, how do you teach it? And I've never even thought of thinking I could teach you how humor works. For me, the funny songs are the gift from the gods. The idea or the line that shows up, utterly a gift. I was on a hike once, and I was trying to find I found a rhyme that was for the word menopausal, and I was dying to use the rhyme for the word menopausal. And I came up with a line, and I built an entire song around the fact that the menopausal line rhyme was in it. And the songs that have done that, and I haven't written one in a number of years, they've often usually come out of actually a lot of frustration and pain, something horrible, and I've come up with a way to laugh at it. I mean, that's the other gift. Helps you laugh at this thing where you're thinking, you know, you can't laugh at it, so.
Well, and you do it, I mean, you do it not only in, yeah, you write songs that have people rolling in the aisle, but you also use humor even in a serious song. And humor and irony, you know,
right.
and even in a serious song. And I think that's something you do is again very, very well.
I was actually warned about it early in my career to stop doing that. that you know, if I would stop playing those songs, that you know, I would do better because people wanted sort of they wanted to know what they were getting from you. You know, that you were like this musician who did that. And I was never that musician because I would be bored myself sitting through that show. So I would go here and here and here. And this woman sat me down. She said, "You do so much better if you just." But I personally like to laugh. It's just that I like to do it. So I, you know, I'm drawn to it.
Well, play us a funny song.
And that, by the way,
with that, right there. No pressure. No, you can go anywhere from Waldo to Welcome to Boston.
I love it when people also, they introduce me, I say, please, they say, what would you like to do? I say anything except that I'm funny. Don't do that. Just, you know, you say that you don't, because it's, that's like, when people want to write a song, they say, I have this humorous line and I'm going to write a song.
Tell
and
me
I
a
say,
joke. Yeah.
And I say, right there, you're dead. If you think you have a humorous line, you know, right there, the word humorous means you don't actually know if something's funny. Humorous isn't a funny word. Funny is a funny word, you know. Let's see. Well, it has to be a good situation that sets it up. This was my house sitter left her nose ring on the back of the toilet when she moved out 1 year. And right there, I mean. It was at a time that I was thinking of getting something pierced because I was in my late 20s, I think, or maybe my late 30s. I was going to come on one of those birthdays where you're thinking, do I pierce myself this time? And I really was, you know, considering about this. And this house sitter, she was just beautiful. And so if she put an earring anywhere in her body, it looked fabulous. And if she tattooed something on her body, it looked fabulous. And I was a musician sitting in a car all the time. You know, I didn't have her navel. It wasn't going to happen no matter what I did. So I decided that, you know, I would write this song and see if anybody else. And that's the other thing about humor. I wrote a song about a yeast infection because I got a $100 speeding ticket on the way to the gynecologist. So I write this song. And for about 20 years, I never had another yeast infection. It's almost like they heal you. They heal you. So I still have never been pierced. But here's. Some people look sexy and fierce when they are multiply pierced. I must be getting too old. All I can think is, how would I get that in and out of my nose? Some people can't. look nice with a metallic device.